And there is the countdown board.
Too cute.
Yeah, the panda.
And the day is not correct. Let's change it.
Okay. Wow, 70
Perfect.
Days.
Perfect. Wow. So
it's
fast.
It's awesome. Rick, the Beijing 2022 Winter Olympics is 2 months away. So what are you going to do to be part of the Olympics?
Well, you know, I was living in Beijing during the 2008 Summer Olympics, and again, everybody can feel the Olympic spirit in the air, and there's something I've got to do.
My way to celebrate the coming Winter Olympics is on roller skates. I can feel the great legacies of the 2008 Summer Olympics left in the Chinese capital. And looking forward to the impact the 2022 Olympics will leave. Venues have changed into the Winter Olympic venues. And most of all, the spirit of the Olympics is spreading over the host cities of Beijing and Zhangjiakou, especially for the younger generation, which is something really intriguing.
Wow, Rick, you're so good at it.
You know, I've been skating in Beijing for about 20 years now, and, you know, things were quite different then. But truthfully, I was watching you riding the bicycle, and you're really excellent.
Since you're so good at roller skating, do you like to learn ice skating?
Wow, you know, I haven't ice skated since I was a kid growing up in Detroit, but I'd really like to try ice skating again.
Okay, I will introduce you to some Chinese figure skating world champion.
Wow, some very professional people. I would love to learn how to ice skate from them. Let's go.
Pang Qing and Tong Jian had competed in 16 World Figure Skating Championships over 22 years as national team pair. They have also been remembered for posting the highest short program score in the figure skating history at the 2010 Vancouver Winter Olympics. The duo retired in 2015 and have launched their own figure skating school.
最早的时候呢，就是我们会获得很多冰迷，包括我们的支持者，他们通过写信，通过在网上留言，给了我们很多正向的这种支持。那随着这个离开赛场之后呢，有更多的时间，我们也有这个责任和义务去推广好这个冰雪项目。花样滑冰呢，改变了我们的人生，我们也希望回馈它。小月太端尖了。Pang
Qing and Tong Jian started their school from zero. After 6 years of hard work, they are training figure skaters for the Chinese national youth team. And in order to spread the sport to the general public, they also teach open classes for people from all walks of life.
Previously, our training课呢，实际上来讲只面向这个青少年，但是呢，我们能够感受到各个群体对冬奥的运动的这个渴望，所以说我们的公益课同样也面向社区。 然后面向这个特定的人群，
就是大家更多的是在电视里看到你，就是感觉触不可及。然后我觉得我们这样办公益课呢，一个是让他们零距离的呢，接近到我们，然后也有一个正确的能量，我们有正确的教练，然后去辅导他们，让他们感受到就是第一堂课一定是你知道如何能够站立，如何能够保护好自己。
体育嘛，尤其是冬奥的一些项目，又迎来了这个2022的这个北京冬奥会，所以说点燃了这样的这个激情。
Wow, it's so cool! You're learning from Pang Qing and Tong Jian.
So how did it feel?
Well, it was a lot of fun. And all those figure skaters, wow, they are so good. And you know, I find there's a lot of enthusiasm that the Chinese are having for winter sports. And it seems like everybody wants to be a part of the Winter Olympics. And I know that some of them actually would like to be in the Winter Olympics, like this guy.
我听说冬奥会在中国，在自己家门口办，当时心里边就燃起来了。我想参加，因为我是17岁才开始滑的雪，因为这个年龄就竞技的话就是太大了。但是我对成绩上也没有太大的要求，就是想通过自己最大的努力，看看有什么可能性。
As Beijing won the bid for the 2022 Olympic Winter Games, Zhang learned that snowboarders could have a chance to qualify for the Games if they competed in certain international events and achieved a certain level of points and rankings during the Olympic qualifying cycle. In 2016, he participated in an international competition for the first time and got the best result among Chinese. Zhang quit his hotel job and relied on several part-time jobs while snowboarding. It was not enough to afford his expenses, and he had to rely on family support. But by 2017, he was able to pay for himself. During these years, Zhang suffered a variety of injuries, including broken hands, a ligament fracture in his right leg, spiral fibula fracture, concussion, and collapsed lung. But his love for and faith in the sport kept him going. Now Zhang is traveling in Europe for more competitions as he fights for his Winter Olympic dream. He put his training and competition videos on his Douyin account, which has more than 200,000 followers.
Well, wishing the best of luck to Zhang Jiahao, who's still trying to get into the Winter Olympics.
Best wishes, very touching story. Mm. And Rick, are you ready to learn something new again?
Well, what is it?
What is it? Ice hockey!
In recent years, Chinese people's passion for ice hockey is rising, especially among young generation. Schools offering ice hockey classes. By the end of 2018, the Beijing Ice Hockey Association has registered more than 3,000 young players and over 150 teams.
Hey, join us.
Well, I'd love to join you, but don't you think it's a little bit too late for me? I never thought that I'd learn hockey one day.
Never say never.在申办奥运成功之后，要比以前多了很多，因为以前北京学的孩子特别少，全北京加起来也没有100人吧。啊，近年有好多从学校啊，从北京市啊，包括这个国家呀、啊，大力的支持，所以现在学的孩子越来越多。啊，强身健体啊，可以通过这个冰球锻炼孩子的意志品质。北京尤其现在孩子嘛，都是多事情比较多。所以他这个集体观念比较薄弱，想让这个孩子多增加一些这种集体观念。
走。
Good luck to Beijing. Better for a future. Good luck to Beijing. Welcome to Beijing.
Together we will grow. Share your smiles in the winter world. You're the miracle. Share your smiles.